27-year-old who has a history of alcohol and drug abuse died of an apparent heart attack. Police in Ancien-Lorette, just outside of Quebec City, were called to this hotel by the management after they heard an altercation had taken place. When police arrived, Kordick appeared intoxicated and was taken to hospital. During the trip, his condition deteriorated, and despite the efforts of emergency medical technicians, he died en route to the hospital. Details of Kordick's deaths are still very sketchy. The details of the autopsy performed earlier this afternoon were released tonight. It says that Kordick died of lung failure related to heart malfunction. For those that knew Kordick, his death was a shock, but really no surprise. He lived life on the edge, both on and off the ice. He had many demons, and in the end, it was the demons that won out.
It is appropriate in many ways that John Kordick spent his entire NHL career fighting. Every game, Kordick battled the toughest players in the league, excelling in hockey's darker side.
It's no secret what I do, you know. If you look at my stats, there's more PIMS there than PTSs.
Kordick was drawn to the darker side of life as well. He became involved with drugs and alcohol. That involvement ended up costing him jobs with several teams. He went from Montreal to Toronto to Washington to Quebec, all within a seven-year NHL career. Teams were afraid to take a chance on him. By the time Kordick reached Quebec, he was fighting off the ice too, trying to beat his addictions. He was sharing a room with Brian Fogarty, who was also fighting alcoholism. But Kordick would wear out his welcome in Quebec too. John Kordick won most of his NHL fights, but he lost his fight against drugs and alcohol. He lost his fight with the law. And after 27 turbulent years, John Kordick lost, period.